Previously, we looked at one man's desire to bring Filipino martial arts into the squared circle. He would combine the versatile and practical attack system of Arnis with the punches and kicks commonly found in kickboxing. Master Nab would add an insane amount of kicks to Yoyan, with a variety of them coming from different angles. For some, Yoyan is a cheap Filipino knockoff of Muay Thai, but for others, it is the Philippines' most lethal martial art. In this video, we will examine many of Josie's attacks and see how well the Morena represents the art. I'm the unknown Fang. And welcome to my channel. Yoyan is an extremely aggressive martial art that employs a lot of combinations. Quite a few martial arts, such as karate, follow the philosophy of Ikin Hitsatsu. An attack is always meant to kill or dismantle. In kickboxing-influenced arts such as Yoyan, there are a sequence of attacks that combine weaker, faster probing attacks with heavier ones from different angles and levels. Josie has a lot of combinations that start with punches, kicks, and even elbows, and Yoyan fighters place a huge emphasis on outside kicks, but are not afraid to get their hands or knees dirty on the inside. We will look at Josie's punches, elbows, kicks, and knees. Some may be hidden in combinations, while others will be far more overt. Kickboxing is firmly planted in the foundations of striking. As a result, Josie has all the tools of a kickboxer, including jabs, straights, hooks, and uppercuts. Like most of boxing-based martial arts, the old 1-2 consists of a left jab followed by a right straight or cross. This 1-2 combination is a quick exchange that can lead into a variety of attacks, including elbows, kicks, knees, and even more punches. Punches that cover all types of angles, such as this liver shot. We already talked about how painful a well-placed shovel hook is, and following up with a cross or straight could mean lights out for the opponent. Following up a shovel hook with a cross is not the only way. Here, Josie changes levels into a low kick, only adding more pain and confusion, finally ending things with a Superman punch. Since Yoyan stresses kicks, it's not uncommon to follow up with a jab or a rear roundhouse. It is an interesting option to finish an exchange with a spinning back kick at such a close range though. One thing to note is that not all combos have to start with a jab. Josie can start with a cross and finish with a knee. As long as the attacks flow smoothly from one into the other, the knee is a great finisher. Josie can also start with an overhead and finish with an even more powerful jumping knee. And finally, Josie has a few uppercuts at her disposal, like the interrupting upper, designed to move under attacks that leave her opponent stunned on counter hit, while others are more direct and overt, leaving defense to the wind. This combination starts with a jab and ends with an elbow. Whereas boxing is limited to hooks, a Yoyan fighter has access to different types of elbows that hit from a variety of angles. Whereas the elbow in the combination was a front elbow, this is a rear one. A front elbow is faster, but the rear one has power on its side. But what if the elbow comes as a counter? Much like Steve's and less like Paul's, Josie has a sway that puts her just out of range of any attack. And if that sway is successful, Josie can deliver another crushing horizontal elbow, tucking her opponent into bed for the night. Josie also has another bedtime story that begins with an elbow and finishes with a hook. After ducking an attack, Josie rises up with a series of attacks that work just like they do in the movies and the UFC. The elbow hits the opponent, raising their chin, and the follow-up is a left hook that finishes the opponent. But this is rather tame compared to running towards the opponent and stepping in while lowering her center of gravity, dropping down until rising up with a brutal rising elbow. This elbow attack starts from the long range and moves in, ducking under high attacks. But sometimes, it's better to attack from the skies. Exactly the polar opposite, this is Josie's jumping elbow that uses her entire body for a downward strike. It is dynamic, but rarely seen in the ring. Instead, it has its place on big screens and YouTube tutorials. Josie also has a grounded version that has a large amount of commitment to the strike. At first, it appears horizontal, but Josie steps in, twisting her body, turning it downward into a chopping elbow. and this motion is also similar to the one adapted when breaking stones or bricks. This is not the best attack for the ring, and it seems more suitable for karate demonstrations. This is probably my favorite elbow, seen in the movies and in the ring. It's a rear spinning elbow that hits downward. By leaning into the blow and turning at the same time, Josie is able to deliver a strike that cuts through her opponent's defenses. It's rarely thrown on its own, and there's usually a setup before the attack, such as a kick or punch. No setup is given here, as Josie leaps forward with a horizontal elbow. Some benefits are that it is faster, and elbows are a great way to cut your opponent's eye up. There were times when Master Knapp would refer to his art as Filipino foot fighting. Of course, he wasn't the only one. Sikiran is another Filipino kicking art that places a huge emphasis on attacks with the foot while the hands mostly block. We've already looked at Yoyan's punches and elbows, but Yoyan has a huge amount of kicks in the Rolodex with targets from all levels. Sometimes Josie kicks are used at the end of her combinations, such as this one that ends with a high roundhouse kick. Following up punches with a kick is commonly known as setting up the kick. The drawbacks to using only kicks is that they require a large amount of energy as well as balance. And that's why ending with kicks is not such a bad idea, especially since kicks are easier to predict. Predictable! But sometimes you can close the distance with a kick. In this case, Josie starts with a teep. While not an actual front kick, this is more of a push kick. Now truth be told, the teep is like the Swiss Army knife of kicks. It can be used as a jab for maintaining distance, interrupting and harassing your opponent, creating distance for a much more devastating full roundhouse kick. Josie also has a more powerful version that covers distance as well. While the teep is usually seen as a jab, this kick is all about stomping through the person. After jumping forward, the main focus is power and much more force on impact. This is another chance for Josie to display her athleticism. Josie starts her offense with a teep and goes into a side flip, ending with a side kick. The acrobatics involved make this an extremely risky move that could hurt both the kicker and the person on the receiving end. Josie ends this combination with a spinning back kick. While the back kick is overlooked in the ring, the spinning back kick is highly revered. Not tied down to one discipline, it can be found in all types of martial arts because of its power. This seems like a strange way to start a combination because of its power, but somehow Josie makes it work. Starting with the most damaging and riskiest kick and ending with a low kick is quite unorthodox. Low kicks are quite devastating attacks that sap away at the opponent's mobility until they can't stand anymore. There are many ways to attack the legs. Josie can rush in with the momentum, or she can drop low and deliver a painful kick recruiting a full turn of the hips. It's a bit slower, but she has much more power. She still does have a decent conventional low kick as well, and while conditioning is necessary, it is a nightmare for martial artists that are not ready for it. Martial artists such as boxers, but it doesn't have to be a one and done. After too many stings to the legs, the focus starts to go there, unfortunately at the cost of higher punches and kicks. Low kicks take time, but one solid kick to the temple could end the match. Solid kicks like a spinning roundhouse after a left elbow. Josie has a variety of roundhouses with a lot of power behind them, but because of her smaller frame, she also has a lot of speed as well. When she needs to cover the distance, this is her roundhouse of choice. Striking with the shin instead of the instep, Josie steps in, bringing a huge amount of momentum to her kick. But sometimes it's nice to have something flashy, and nothing says flashy like a spinning 540. With the setup from the spin, it's quite similar to Eddie's Unblockable. But focusing on a jumping roundhouse instead, it has a slower start, but the opponent could easily be confused by the spin, and it has a surprising success rate in the ring. Starting with a straight right, this combo ends with a high left knee to the opponent's head. Knee strikes come in a lot of varieties, from jumping to grappling attacks, and targets for the knee include the midsection as well as ducking opponents. Another combination that we've seen before starts from a teep and ends the same way. A teep can be used as a jab, leading to a damaging knee from the opposing leg. From this combination, Josie fakes a low kick after her first knee and doubles down with another knee instead. For anyone attempting to block or catch that low kick, this has a disastrous ending. Yet, sometimes all you need is a simple rising knee. It's not too complicated, but it's still a powerful attack that gets the job done and leaves your opponents grounded. Another knee, with the target being much higher, depending on the flexibility of the user, pulling down on the head is not necessary to generate enough force for a knockout. Now, if you really want to increase your damage output even more, it's time to take to the air for a jumping attack that starts from the right knee, finishing with the left. This can be used at many different ranges, but jumping knees are risky, as missing the attack could place the attacker in a much more vulnerable position, and nothing is more closer than grappling range. After a counter hit, Josie continues the attack, seizing her opponent and destroying them with a knee to the midsection as they crumple to the ground. But sometimes, the knee comes first with an elbow following it. After a knee, the elbow becomes the icing on the cake. But sometimes one knee is not enough. Since Josie can choose to double down with two knees into the midsection and then finish them off with another brutal elbow. Finally, look at some techniques that really distinguish Yoyan from other forms of kickboxing. This is the bolo. And just like how the bolo punch in boxing was influenced by the swing of the blade, many other attacks can also think are needs for their creation. Here we see a combination of bolo punches. Josie starts with a leading hook and ends with a back fist. And this is the same motion that could easily be applied using a yanatok or blade in her hand. Josie has another grappling move that ends with another set of bolo punches. This time they're upright, but they follow the principles of Alasan. I guess bearing the name Arnis makes this combo low-hanging fruit, but we can see another leading hook followed by a bolo uppercut, then a right knee, finish up with a snapping roundhouse. This bending backhand is the pride and joy of Yoyan. It's a surprising attack that many are just not prepared for. Turning your back to your opponent means losing sight of them, and in fighting, seconds and inches matter. Many are not prepared for this spinning attack that recruits the momentum of the entire body, and as a result, the Rokas is quite successful in a ring and outside. The Mountain Storm Kick is a roundhouse kick that drops down like a lightning bolt. Quite similar to the question mark kick, it also brings a huge amount of weight onto the opponent as well. In Josie's case, much like the intercept kick, she adds some acrobatics to it. The 540 kick is usually a spinning crescent kick with the inside of the kicking foot impacting the surface. Variations do include turning it into a jumping roundhouse, but Josie's butterfly edge follows the striking path of the mountain storm kick, combining it with a jumping attack. Sweeps in kickboxing are usually from standing positions. After catching a foot, the kickboxer steps in and trips their opponent. Backspinning kicks are quite risky and do not carry the same protection as a spinning backhand. The Cyclone Sweep has some varied success, and Josie does have a follow-up. This grappling move begins with a twisting arm lock, which is quite common in Arnis. With one arm incapacitated, the right side is exposed for two round kicks to the midsection, and she finally finishes her opponent off with a jumping push kick, quite similar to a needle shot. Josie truly embodies Yoyan. She has the punches, elbows, knees, and kicks. While she doesn't have a pair of striking gloves or a yanatok, she does have many Arnis attacks. For this reason, I have to give Josie an 8.5 out of 10. For the most part, I'm quite happy with her animations. In the next video, we will compare her to the other kickboxers in other fighting games. And we'll also look at some possible additions or modifications to our move list. Thanks again for watching. God bless. Fang Wei, out.